In this video, we consider an example of sensitivity analysis where we change the objective function coefficients. So we have the following LP and we have the optimal tableau given to us already. And the first thing we do is we look at which variables are basic and which variables are non-basic in this optimal tableau. So let's create an additional column here for basic variables. And it's obvious by looking at the column that the basic variables are going to be x3 and s2. So x3 is going to be the basic variable in row 1 and s2 is going to be the basic variable in row 2. So part A asks for the optimal solution of this LP. This is very straightforward. We just need to read the values of the original variables x1, x2 and x3 from the optimal tableau. So we see that only x3 is basic among these variables and the value of x3 is 2. The value of non-basic variables is 0 and the optimal objective value is 4. And we can verify, of course, when we plug in x3 equal to 2 in the objective, we get 4. Next, in part B, we need to find the optimal solution of the dual. So the optimal solution of the dual is something that we read from row 0. More specifically, we look at the columns corresponding to the slack variables and we see that y1 star is going to be equal to 2, y2 star is going to be equal to 0. And W, the optimal dual objective value, must be the same as primal, so it's going to be 4. And again, dual objective is given by 2y1 plus 12y2. So obviously, it's going to be equal to 4 when we plug in this vector in the dual objective. The next three questions concern with determining of the ranges of the objective function coefficients for which the current basis will remain optimal. The way this question is answered strongly depends on whether the variable we are talking about is basic or non-basic. So x1 and x2 are non-basic variables, and for non-basic variables the answer is pretty straightforward. We just need to look at the reduced cost for these variables. So for x1 the reduced cost is 12, for x2 the reduced cost is 5. And what is the reduced cost? The reduced cost is by how much the coefficient for our decision variable needs to increase in order for this variable to enter the basis. And for x1, this delta is given by 12. All right, so the coefficient needs to increase at least by 12 in order for this variable to enter the basis. And of course, if you reduce this coefficient, then the current basis will remain optimal because x1 is not a part of the optimal basis. And if the profit you get from this variable is even less, obviously it's not going to enter the basis, right? So therefore, the answer to this question is going to be from negative infinity to 12 plus 4, 16. So similarly for x2, the reduced cost is 5 and the range is going to be from negative infinity to 5 plus 1, which is the current coefficient. So negative infinity to 6. All right, so finally x3 is a basic variable, so in this case we need to do a little more work. We actually need to compute the vector of non-basic variable coefficients in row 0 and make sure that it remains non-negative in the tableau form or non-positive in the dictionary form. So let's do it in the dictionary form, for which the formula is Cn transposed minus Cb transposed B inverse times n, and we need to make sure that this remains less than or equal to 0 after we make the change, right? So we are making the change to the vector Cb, and b inverse times n can be read from our tableau, all right? So b inverse times n in our tableau is given by the columns corresponding to the non-basic variables. Our non-basic variables are x1, x2, and s1. So b inverse times n is then the column for x1 first, 8, negative 2, then for x2, 3, negative 2, and then for s1, 1, negative 1. Cn transposed is given by 4, 1, and 0. So it's important to keep in mind that in the formulas that we have for the revised simplex tableau or dictionary, all these parameters here refer to the original problem data that we read from here, not from here. So our vector CB is given by the basic variables would be x3 and s2. The coefficient for x3 is 2. The coefficient for s2 is 0 in our original problem. So we have 2, 0 here. And for the case we are discussing, we are going to try to change the coefficient for x3. So we'll have 2 plus delta instead of 2. So we'll have 2 plus delta 0 multiplied by b inverse times n. It's 8, 3, 1 in the first row, negative 2, negative 2, negative 1 in the second row. And what we get as a result is for the first entry is going to be 4 minus 2 plus delta times 8 is minus 12 and minus 8 delta from here. Then for the second entry, we will have 1 minus this vector multiplied by the second column. So it will be 1 minus 6 plus 3 delta. So minus 5 minus 3 delta. And finally, for the last entry, we'll have 0 minus 2 plus delta. So minus 2 minus delta. So this is our vector for the non-basic variable coefficients after we add delta to this coefficient right here. And we need to make sure that this vector, every entry of it is less than or equal to 0. So we solve the system negative 12 minus 8 delta is less than or equal to 0. Minus 5 minus 3 delta is less than or equal to 0. And minus 2 minus delta is less than or equal to 0. So this is equivalent to 8 delta is greater than or equal to negative 12. So delta is greater than or equal to minus 12 over 8 or negative 3 halves. So from the second inequality, delta is greater than or equal to negative 5 thirds. And from the third one, delta is greater than or equal to negative 2. So for all of these to hold at the same time, we need to pick the largest of the three. So delta is greater than or equal to negative 3 halves. So this is our lower bound on the increase in the coefficient for x3 in the objective, which corresponds to c3 being greater than or equal to negative 3 halves plus the initial coefficient of 2, which is the same as 1 half. So the range for C3 is from 1 half to plus infinity. Finally, part F asks for the inverse of B, and the inverse of B can be read from the columns corresponding to the slack variables in our tableau. We just need to make sure that the variables in the rows are arranged the same way they're arranged in the columns. So x3 goes before s2 here. Therefore, the order is right. And we can see that the columns corresponding to the basic variables form the identity matrix. So this means that we can read the inverse of B directly from here. So we have 1, 0, negative 1, 1. And we can verify that if we multiply this matrix by our B, which is the column for x3 is 1, 1, and the column for s2 is 0, 1, then the product of B by this matrix is going to give us the identity matrix. So this is indeed the inverse of B. Done.